for me, it was really tough to not only process but accept this was something that was actually happening.
I didn't know anything about blood clots. I'd never heard of them before. I hadn't seen girls or boys on my team diagnosed with these before. I didn't know of anybody diagnosed with them before.
The only form of blood clot I was really familiar with at the time was like strokes, I think, and some heart attacks. I always thought they occurred in elderly people or people with like really poor lifestyles, which, so I never thought they would ever happen to me, someone who was young and physically active.
Once I found out, I was first off confused, like, what is a blood clot? I've never heard of those before.
Blood clots are clumps of blood, including proteins in the blood known as coagulation factors, platelets and red blood cells, which harden over time to stop cuts and wounds from bleeding. One of the most common types of blood clots in children is what we call deep vein thrombosis, or DVT, which is caused by a blood clot that occurs in the deep venous system. DVT can occur in the deep veins of a leg or of an arm, when the blood clot fills the interior of the vein, obstructing the blood flow and causing complications. Another type of blood clot can also happen in the lungs, called pulmonary embolism, which happens when a small piece of a fresh blood clot breaks free and travels through the veins of the body into the lung, blocking again blood flow to a part of the lung. Blood clots located in the arms and legs, or DVTs, can be accompanied by limb swelling, pain, and changes in the color of the skin, making it reddish or bluish. Symptoms of clots in the lungs, for example, pulmonary embolism, would include chest pain and shortness of breath.
When I was diagnosed with my blood clot, I was at the field with my family, and my legs were hurting a lot, and I was very dizzy. So we walked home. After a while of me not being able to walk on my leg, my mom took me to SickKids.
It started off with a growing discomfort in my left leg, mainly during physical activities such as like running or walking. And as someone who grew up playing sports and participating in like martial arts for several years, my family and I brushed it off as a sort of like muscle injury.
So I woke up one morning with a lot of pain in my leg. My whole life was football at the time, and I had a football game and I was not missing it for the world. So I kept it quiet and I went and played some football. But then after the game, it didn't get better, it actually got worse.
Eventually the pain got so bad that I couldn't even like make the walk back home from the bus stop.
I was at rowing practice after a normal day at school and my arm turned bright blue and got really swollen.
That morning I woke up and my left leg had swollen to around twice, I'd say, its normal size. It turned a dark purple and I had excruciating pain all along the inside of my thigh and up into my groin.
So we went to the emergency room.
And after a couple hours of waiting, ultrasound, blood work,
they diagnosed me with a small blood clot.
DVT are usually diagnosed by an image method called ultrasound, which is a medical test that uses sound waves to obtain images of the structures inside of the body, such as the blood flow through a vein. In some cases, other imaging tests may be required. To diagnose a pulmonary embolism, a tomography, which is a special type of X-ray of the lungs, or a ventilation perfusion scan that measures the air and the blood supply to the lungs might be required.
I couldn't go back in time and change what had happened. I couldn't pretend like it wasn't there.
It made me extremely scared.
I clearly remember standing in the waiting room with a bunch of strangers around, just my dad and I, and just standing there crying because I was so scared.
First couple days, it was really, really rough.
Honestly, the first thing running through my head and the thing I was most worried about was that I was gonna have to quit my sport.
At the end of the day, there was only really one thing I could do, which was just try and be as strong as I could to get through this and hope that the people around me would be able to help me.
It really helps to remain positive, as cliche as it sounds, right? Diagnosis, no matter how bad or how scary it may be, is always the first step to recovery.
While blood clots may be rare in children, they do happen. If you think that you have a blood clot because you have a painful and swollen leg or problems breathing with or without chest pain, please make sure you reach out to your medical team or visit an emergency room for further evaluation. Please do not feel afraid to speak up to your healthcare provider if you believe you may have a blood clot. And remember, guys, you're not alone. an experienced thrombosis team can help you understand what causes blood clots, how they are treated, and strategies for blood clot prevention in the future.